Yeah. So coming to this Oracle Fusion Technical. So it's actually, there are different aspects of this Oracle Fusion Technical, what people want to learn. Some people would be learning like very specific to specific, like, you know, the area, for example, Fusion HCM Technical. Some people like, you know, asking for Fusion Finance Technical. And then there is a lot of confusion, like, you know, what is considered technical, what is considered functional. So in the context of Oracle Fusion, so there are a lot of things you can do through configuration point of view. Okay. So anyway, so going back a little bit like to the background. So when you say Oracle apps, generally what we are doing is coming to the technical side. You have a database, like mostly we'll be working with the database technologies, SQL and PLSQL, etc. When we go to Oracle apps, we also have OAF. So that's how in Oracle apps. Coming to Fusion, what Oracle has done, Oracle has developed something called Oracle Fusion Middleware first, FMW, right? So the Fusion Middleware is the technology which is, like, you know, the used behind the scene. Oracle Fusion is using FMW as a technology. Whereas if you look at Oracle apps, the technology behind Oracle apps is like mostly database, SQL, PLSQL, all that stuff. Coming to FMW, it is a Fusion, it is a FMW. What is FMW? Primarily, we can say FMW, there are like four modules. One is Oracle ADF.
Okay.
And then we have Oracle SOA. And then we call OBIE and then OIM. These are the four modules. Okay, why these four modules are important? In fact, there are many other modules also. But these are the four major areas, like, you know, what I would consider as like important for Fusion applications. Why? Because the Fusion applications itself, this is using now, like, you know, the all new web-based standards. And we can also say Java-based standards. And then, like, it's also using web services. Like, they are the main. When I say, sorry.
What I stand OIM stand for?
That is Oracle Identity Management.
Okay.
Oracle Identity Management. And this one is Oracle Business Intelligence. Oracle Business Intelligence.
Mainly this is the reporting tool, right?
Yeah, right. Enterprise Edition. Right. So now, exactly, that is a reporting tool, yeah. So now you take any web-based application. The main architecture what we follow is MVC. That is called Model View Controller. Hmm. You would have heard this. Right?
Yes.
So why we are having model view? There are like always three layers. One, like we are talking about UI, which is called view. And then we have, we also have,
like an application module or controller, then which have an OAF, right?
Yeah, similar to OAF. So this is, we also have web server, or we call application server. And then we also have the database. There's a backend. Yeah. So this is in fact the very standard architecture what is followed for any web-based applications. So what we are doing there, we develop the database schema, complete like the schema what we need for the application. And then we also developing the UI, like you have the different UI pages, which are completely HTML pages. So when you say UI, this is always like web-based UI in terms of, in case of web-based applications. And then we also have one more thing. This is also called mid-tier. The mid-tier is nothing but the web server. So what happens here, whenever you take any UI, let's say I'm creating a customer, I have a form for that UI. When I enter all the form details, like customer details, and click on submit, so that has to create one entry in the database. Like you'll be having some database table for customers. Correct? Now, what happens in case of web-based applications, the request direct will not directly go from UI to database. It always submits to, the request gets submitted to the mid-tier, the web server, right? So now the web server, what we're having, some business components. When you say business components or software side components, so it's a set of Java, like, you know, the programs or In case of ADF, we call like ADF business components. So it's a set of programs which are like already like part of application, and we have the UI. So now when the request comes to web server understands for this specific request, what is the Java component or the server side component responsible for completing the request. So based on that, it is going to forward the request to appropriate server side component. Now the server side component knows how to handle or how to communicate with the database. It might be having some logic also. On top of that, ultimately it has to go and make entry into database. So that will be generally happening with the help of JDBC. So what we are talking here, we are having HTML, JavaScript, CSS, etc. And here we have Java, basically Java, JSP, servlets, and then we have Hibernate. There are different technologies, okay? And I was just mentioning the main protocol used between communication between the server and the database, that is called JDBC. So using JDBC, they'll be communicating with the database, and eventually it is going to execute some SQL statements only, but with the help of JDBC. That's how it works in any Java-based applications, in the web applications.
Okay.
The same thing happens in the reverse direction also. So when I have a page, I want to search list of customers, or I want to search I want to get the details of a given customer based on the customer ID. Same thing, the request gets submitted, and the input in this case the customer ID, and the web server knows basically there is something called controller here. The controller is nothing but usually it will be servlet or something. So the controller is going to identify for this request what Java component, the server-side component has to be picked. So the request will be forwarded to their server-side components. So the server-side component will be having all the logic which is developed by the the actual application is part of application. And that is going to again communicate with the database. It's going to query now, select statement based on the customer ID, get the details, and then convert the details into HTML. Because the UI, in case of the browser, it that understands only HTML. So the server has to, your application has to take care of converting that whole thing into HTML. So this whole thing is very standard. You take any web-based application, that's how it works. Okay. So now, why we are talking about this? Because we are not developing any directly HTML pages or CSS or JavaScript when you're talking about Fusion applications development or integration. But this is very important to understand the standard, what are the used behind the scene. And in case of what happens is, even the Fusion applications, the development team, which is in Oracle, they are also not using directly these technologies. In fact, they are using other frameworks. That framework is part of your FMW. So what they use is, instead of using your, by the way, this is called view, and there is a controller here, and this part is called model, your database plus your server side components. So that is called the model. So model, view is your UI, and then you have a controller will be usually a satellite, and then the model will be the combination of your server side components and the database. These both are together called model. So that is the architecture. Now here, Oracle FMW, the Fusion applications are developed using FMW. Now what FMW is going to, how it is going to help us here? In case of, in this case, I mentioned these technologies, right? Instead of these technologies, what it does is Oracle ADF. Oracle ADF, in fact, comprises of all these technologies. It has two layers. One is called Oracle ADF Faces, and then ADF Business Components. ADF Faces is used for developing the UI in case of Fusion. So you take any Fusion application UI.
That's an ADF.
Sorry?
Oh, that was ADF Face, all the pages of front end UI.
Yeah, the front end, correct.
Ah.
The front end is completely ADF. And not only that, in case of Fusion, the back end, the business, the server side components are also part of ADF, the ADF business components. And then we have the database, which is of course the complete, like, you know, your backend database. That is the, so ADF itself is a very generic technology which can be used for developing any enterprise based web applications. Okay, so the same technology is used in the Fusion applications, right? Now, right. What is Oracle SOA? Oracle SOA is used for integration or dealing with web services. Why this is required? Now you think about any large enterprise based application like ERP, where you're having different modules, functional modules like HCM, supply chain management, and then you have the financials, CRM, all this stuff. So there should be a mechanism to communicate along with, like, you know, all these modules. So there should be a way to exchange the messages among all these modules. There should be a way to integrate between the Fusion applications and custom applications, right? Your enterprise may have Fusion alongside, like, you know, Fusion, you may be using many other custom applications for other areas. So now we need some technology to integrate and exchange the messages, the data among all these applications. So in case of Fusion, so what Oracle has done, Oracle actually put a lot of, like, you know, research, like, you know, before they decided what exactly they should be developing from the technology point of view. You take any application now, what you need, first you need some technology which is going to help in this, like, you know, end-to-end development. That is the ADF. And once you have the develop, you need some technology for integration. Correct. Among the different applications. That is Oracle SOA. Then you also need some technology for reporting. So every day to day, like, you know, you'll be having different kind of reports for different people in the enterprise, in the company. So then, like, you know, how easily you can get the reports out of the application. So that's where, like, you know, they developed separate technology called OBIEE. OBIEE, like, you know, there are two different layers. One is RPD modeling, and then you're also having report, like, you know, this is called dashboards and analysis. This is pretty simpler. So once you have the RPD, and as part of that, they also develop subject areas. This is part of, like, you know, in case of Fusion now, everything is developed already. The application is developed. You have the business components, like, you know, sitting in the server, the UI, which, like, you know, end user is using. It's also exposing different SOA services, like, you know, which will be used for exchanging the exchanging, like, you know,
messages.
Yeah. So communicating, like, you know, like your inbound and outbound integration with Fusion. Now, from the reporting point of view, it already has this RPD and subject areas built. So what they're exposing to the users are, users are nothing but, like, you know, our integration, like, you know, the consultants, subject areas. So using subject areas, now we'll be able to build our own dashboards and analysis, like, you know, on the based on, like, you know, our requirements. We can build different kind of reports. It's pretty easy. You need not be too technical for that. So functionally, if you understand, like, you know, the relationship between different objects, then the relationship is already built in this layer. So we will be able to build the reports much, like, you know, faster way.
Okay.
Now you see, it is so nicely organized. You like, you know, there is one technology for developing application, one technology for integration. And one technology for reporting, right? And then the identity management is used for security. Like, you need different roles and responsibilities. So that whole thing is maintained and managed, like, you know, as part of OIM, that is separate server actually, which is sitting in the Fusion. Okay.
Okay.
So now, have clarity, this technology is not specific to Fusion applications. Okay. The Fusion middleware itself is very generic technology. Now, I can be, like, you know, some company where I'm not using our Fusion applications. I'm not using, like, you know, ERP or HCM, anything I'm not using. But I can even use my Oracle FMW to build my own applications, custom applications from scratch using ADF. I can build integrations using SOA. I may be having multiple applications, SAP, something from Microsoft, something like my built application. Then, like, if you want very complex integration requirements, I can go for Oracle SOA. And I may not be using any of these things. I may be having, like, you know, multiple databases, and I would like to, like, you know, pull the data from different sources, different, like, you know, databases, and build, like, my RPD modeling, and then like I would like to create one like the framework for my reporting. That you can use for OBIEE. Using OBIEE, you can achieve that. So now, just to what the point what I'm making, if anybody knows these technologies, the scope is not just Fusion. That is beyond the Fusion applications. They can
so
be
you can, yeah, Bhaskar, we can show that the way we can develop a custom application for that as well. Not a Fusion, but the other custom application as per the business requirement. For
exactly.
That.
If you know ADF, you can develop that easily. Okay, so that's a, yeah, exactly. So that's a, for example, in case of OAF, that is not possible, right? In case of OAF, you have to work within like no applications, Oracle applications, which is very different in this case. Okay. That is the idea. And Oracle has made everything like no industry standard in Fusion. Like everything is like no web service here. Any interface like no what you need from the Fusion applications, that will be a web service. That is internally using SOA. But as a end point, it will be a web service only. Okay, now this just background. How we are going to learn? What we are going to learn in this training is we are going to start with Oracle SOA first. We are not learning Oracle ADF starting with. We are starting with Oracle SOA because our main intention in this training is not to develop the custom applications. Okay, that could be also a requirement. But that is optional, as I said. But you will be always, the main requirement will be for the, as a Fusion technical developer, and the Fusion technical like no consultant, there will be a lot of requirement for the integration and maybe reporting. Okay.
Yeah.
So for the integration, to do that integration, like no, to get expertise in that specific area, we're starting with Oracle SOA. Okay, in Oracle SOA, what we are doing is we are starting with very basics, like no fundamentals. First, we are going to understand. We are going to understand what is a web service first, like a very basic way. In fact, just to get give an idea, the web service itself is like no using again internally the web based like no the same web technology concept only internally. There is no new technology it is using. Web service is internally nothing but web technology. What is web technology? Web technology is nothing but to access any application, like I type something here, Amazon or something, I'm able to access that application and I'm getting like no some response and that is displayed in the browser. So how I'm communicating to the server? I'm communicating the server by using URL. That means, see, in the integration, what is the biggest hurdle? The biggest hurdle is heterogeneous technologies. Heterogeneous technologies.
Okay.
And also, the applications may not be just like in the same location. Sometimes like your network is like widespread. So these are the like the challenges. Challenges in the integration. Or you have different technologies, like I have one application which is developed using Java, one application like which is developed using some maybe like Microsoft Microsoft technologies, some applications may be like SAP, some applications are part of my Oracle ERP. So every technology is different there, but I would like to exchange the messages among all these applications. So that is the biggest challenge. Then they are not together, like they may not be on the same server, they may not be like sitting like close to one by one, like they may be in the different networks, etc. They're remotely available. So now that is the reason we need like some technology which is going to help us. Still like we have these challenges, but we would like to provide a solution. That is possible the moment you have the web service. The web service makes whole thing, this is going to make, how it is going to make like help us, the web service is always available as URL. Any functionality, when you say web service, that means that functionality you can access with the help of URL. So what happens in web service is part of the development. Once you develop this functionality, that functionality has to be deployed onto a server, the web server, so that the functionality will be exposed as a URL.
So now once the URL is available, the URL itself is like, no, will be a technology independent. Because you see here, when I'm typing the URL, I don't care about, I don't bother about what is my, like, no, the technology used in the server. What is the technology used in the browser application? I don't care. I'm able to communicate with the client, which is the browser, and the server, which is like, no, sitting remotely somewhere, and I don't care about the technology, but I'm able to access. So that's exactly what we're achieving with the help of web service also, because it's becoming URL. The moment it becomes URL, then everything becomes like, no, technology independent. Technology independent and also location independent. Naturally, because it is using
URL.
Yeah, URL, and we are going to communicate using HTTP protocol. The same protocol like, no, we also use between browser and like, no, in the normal HTML, like, no, when you're accessing anything to browser also. So that is the reason the web service is very powerful, and this has become very successful in the market. So most of the integrations now, if you see, they'll be based on web service. That is nothing but the client and the server, they're exchanging the messages using web services. So the provider has to expose a web service, and whoever wants to access that web service, they are going to act as a web service client. So here the client and service can be in different technologies and can be in different locations. That is the whole concept of web service.
Correct.
So now we are going to understand like those concepts from the scratch in Oracle SOA training. Then we are going to understand about what is XML, what is XSD, what is WSDL, like all that stuff. After that, we'll be moving to the Oracle SOA concepts. Oracle SOA, like, we have different concepts and different components and different tools. Like, the tools, when I say we have the JDeveloper, you might be using JDeveloper for OAF. And then we're talking about WebLogic Server, WebLogic Server Console, EM Console. We're going to use all those tools. The tools will be, we're going to use JDeveloper, we are going to use WebLogic Server, we are going to understand like, no, WebLogic Server, WebLogic Console, and then we are having Oracle FMW EM Console or Controller, we say like, no, both. These are the tools. Then we are going to start with other concepts. It is a mediator. This is used for routing and transformation. We are going to, in fact, transformation is very, very important in any integration. So we are going to understand like, no, what is a transformation, how to use SSLT transformation, all that stuff. So what is a mediator? Mediator is basically a concept, a component available as part of Oracle SOA, which can be used for like accessing an existing web service and route that like to different service or different target, and also do the transformation. Transformation, because in the integration, we're having source and target. So between the source and target, the message structure might change. The way they are representing the same data, it could be different structure.
It's a different way, right?
Yeah. So yeah. Then we need the transformation. That exactly what we'll be doing as part of transformation. So that is the first component in Oracle SOA. Then you are going to learn BEPL, which is like, no, very, very most important concept as part of Oracle SOA. This is actually the full form is Business Process Execution Language. Business Process Execution Language. This is in fact a combination of programming language, which like, no, programming language means you can write any complex logic. Like I can use if statement, for loop, while loop, like all those things are like available in BEPL. But you are doing everything drag and drop. We are not writing any code like coding like that. We are declaring everything, we are configuring and like, no, developing. In the BEPL, we are going to start with basics, and then we are going to like to go with in depth like no advanced concepts in BEPL. How to invoke like different kind of web services. And then dealing with very advanced activities, like there's something called pick activity, receive activity, then flow activity, using for loops, like, you know, how to manipulate or process different XMLs, where you're having multiple objects, like, you know, all those, everything, like, you know, we are going to learn end to end in BEPL. And the BEPL is very, very powerful in the integration, specifically where you have some complex logic, like, you know, maybe you want to developing logic and like then you want to invoke multiple web services. So the combination here is invoking web services and also develop complex logic. So we also use one word called web service orchestration. So of course we'll be understand like in depth in detail in the training. So but yeah, here two main concepts and components we're going to use in Oracle SOA, and then we have the adapters. In fact, we're going to start adapters like along with mediator. The adapters are used for in SOA whenever you want to communicate anything which is external to your Oracle SOA application, what you're developing, like you want to communicate with files, you want to communicate with the database, or you want to communicate with ERP, like you want to communicate with any technology which is not part of SOA, then you need adapters. So Oracle SOA comes along with like a bunch of adapters. So the adapter is going to act as a web service for SOA. See, the SOA, the main concept in SOA is developing application. For example, here this is a, like no, my SOA application I'm building. In fact, I can. I'm just muting you for a moment. I'm just getting some noise.
Okay.
Or you won't talk. Okay, sorry for that.
Okay.
Yeah. So here, if you look at this application, I'm having different things here. So I have a mediator, I have a BPL, I have a human task, and these are my external references. So this is my application. I'm exposing this application as using some as a service. And I would like to invoke different services which are external to me. That's very, very important. So I'm making integration between and developing a business process. As part of that, I would like to invoke some external services. So that is what you're going to do in the BPL. Okay, so in the BPL, you will be developing, so you will be developing the flow and then you're going to invoke different services. Okay, so coming back to here, so we are going to talk about file adapter, database adapter, then JMS adapter. These are the some adapters, and there are a lot of things, certain configurations we need in for the adapters. We're going to learn, we're going to work in a project as part of SOA from starting after every session you'll be working on one module in the project. So by end of the SOA training, you will be understanding how to use different technologies, different concepts and different components of Oracle SOA, and build a very comprehensive application by putting everything together. In fact, we're also going to learn human task, business rules. These are part of Oracle SOA, again, very powerful. This is used for approvals. This is used for dynamic rules. We'll be discussing in detail in the training. I'm just giving very high level. And then we're also going to learn there is something called EDN. This is called event-based event delivery network. So these are the different concepts. Every concept is, in fact, it's very wide here. I'm just putting in one word here. So we are going to work, understand the theory. You are going to work on practices. I'm going to demonstrate everything how to develop these applications with the help of these components. And I will be giving some assignments. Not only assignments, as I said, there is one project which you are going to work on also. So this is Oracle SOA. After this, so what we are doing here we are not talking anything specific to Fusion applications. We are learning Oracle SOA technology as a generic technology. We are understanding integration methodologies. We are understanding how to use different concepts and components of Oracle SOA. Then we are going to jump into Fusion apps. Cloud, on the cloud, that is also we call SaaS. So there will be during this time we are going to install Oracle SOA completely on your own laptop and desktop, and you are going to practice everything in your laptop only locally. Okay, and I'm going to share every recording after every session, and you'll be able to run any number of times. You can go back and understand the concept. If anything is not like no clear, if you forget anything, all those things are possible. When you come back in the next session, we are going to like to take your doubts based on like what you worked on in the project. If you have any questions, if you're stuck on anything, all those things we'll be discussing. So then coming to Fusion applications, so then we'll be using like our Fusion applications server. Hopefully it is up. We'll just see. Sometimes the server will be down. This is coming from Oracle Cloud. So then we'll be introducing like your Fusion UI. We are going to understand like the high level flow, how the UI is like organized, all that stuff. We are still not talking anything about integration. So we are going to understand like your complete UI, etc. Fusion UI, all the stuff we are going to understand here, and how to navigate across like what is the navigation available, all those things, right? Okay, then what we're going to learn is we're going to start with, there's something called BI publisher reports. So here you will be able to create BI publisher report based on like some specific SQL statement, etc. Once you create that report, the next thing, this is where we're going to talk about the integration. Download the BIP report, okay, with the manually. First thing you are going to do manually, then what you are going to do, I want to download this using my SOA client. So I would like to develop a SOA which is running on premise, which is running in my laptop. I would like to write like SOA. I would like to download this BIP report by using a SOA service, a web service which is available in the Fusion applications. In the Fusion applications, there is a SOA service called report service. First of all, we're going to understand how to find these different services available in the Fusion, which UI is going to help us. We're going to understand that. Then once you go there, how you are going to search for the service. Once you get the service, how can you get the details of the web service? How can you get the WSDL URL for that web service? All that you are going to understand. And then how to understand what is the input, what is output. All the concepts what you learn in Oracle SOA will be like coming handy in these stages when you're talking about developing your integration or developing your clients for integrating with the Fusion applications. So this is one use case we're talking about, downloading your report service, BIP report with the help of report service available in Fusion. Then after this, what we're going to learn is we're going to learn OBIEE reports. This is, you already have a subject areas available. I was telling what is OBIEE. So based on the subject areas, I would like to create my beautiful reports. I would like to create some tables. I would like to add a lot of filters. I would like to add some graphs, etc. So how to go and create those reports? So this is creating or building dashboards and analysis. We are going to understand, again, this is not integration. This is, again, we are doing manual. But this is a very important topic we are going to learn about that. After this, we are going to, for personalization and customization, using sandbox method. What is sandbox method? So here you can create, you can go and change customize different fields, field related customize different sections of the page. When I say different sections, what you can do, you can change the order of the fields, change labels, hide or show existing from the existing fields, etc. This is a page customization. Then you'll be able to do theme customization. Theme customization means here, let's say I want to change the my logo, or I want to say all the headings of my applications should be my pages should be in some manner, all the buttons should be in some manner. You will be able to theme level, you will be able to change your themes, etc. using theme customization. Then adding my own links. I would like to add my own link. When I go to my application here, let's say I want to add something when I go to, there could be something for example here, I want to add my own a link here so that I will be able to navigate to my own report automatically. For example, you can see this is a custom link, what I added, like that, like how to add my own links, etc. Using personalization. So this is called like, you know, then understanding like, you know, your sandbox methodology. First of all, what is sandbox, how to create sandbox, and then how to apply sandbox. Once you apply the sandbox, then like, you know, you're going to the customization, then how to publish the sandbox. So this is part of your personalization customization. This we are not using any of integration technologies, but you understand like, you know, from a technical point of view, we are learning that point. After that, we are going to understand a little bit more customization with the help of flex field concept. So how we are going to like understand what flexibles are possible in which page. And once you know like what flexibles are there, possible, like how you can create that, all that we are going to learn. And then after that, you're also going to work with lookups and value sets, all that, like you create a new value set and you want to integrate, like use that in the flex field what you created. Or you already have some lookups, you want to add your own fields to lookups. Look, we are going to learn that one. This is all like, again, nothing integration. We are understanding like one learning this customization. After this comes with another concept called FBDI, that is file-based data input. This is very, very useful technology or tool available in Fusion. And this is very widely used like, you know, as part of implementation and also like, you know, a ongoing integration also. So migration, basically you have like, you know, data available in some other application, I mean the existing ERP. Now you would like to like, you know, migrate the data, you want to use bulk import Fusion application, you're having FBDI concept. So here first you are going to learn manually, you know, there are different steps required as part of this, like, you know, you'll be understanding. In fact, even before this, we are going to understand what is UCM, that is the content management, nothing but like, you know, file import, export, etc. And that you are going to use here because one of the steps in FBDI, first you are going to understand FBDI process. There is a documentation available, and from the documentation, you'll be understanding like, you know, what all different modules, like, you know, you will be able to use FBDI for. And for every module, how to get the information, how to download the templates, how to prepare the data. And once you prepare the data, you have to export, you have to first like upload the data into your UCM. After that, you have to submit one job and you have to like now monitor the job. After the job, like now how you can identify or cross verify whether your import is successful. All that we're going to first understand manually. And once manually is done, because there are multiple steps available, that is okay. But our main focus is how to automate that. And when you automate, by the way, I'll just come back to this. Even in the BIP report, we are doing this using report service. We are doing, in fact, three different flavors. With the help of SOA, there is also something called SOAP UI. I'm going to use all these different client-side technologies. Other one is Java. Now, what you will be doing here, when you automate here, you are going to use SOA. Completely, of course, you can do the same thing with Java also, but we are going to use again SOA client here. Whatever you learned, the Beppel concepts, etc., adapters concepts, etc., all those things becomes handy to here to automate like, you know, this complete process end to end. With the help of our programs, like, you know, the SOA application, what you're developing, you'll be able to upload your file, you're going to trigger the service, you are going to download your status, you are going to do everything what you need to do end to end. And that is really, really very, very complex thing what you can achieve with the help of your SOA concepts and with the help of your integration like, no, concepts what you learned. So this is what like, no, mostly like, no, you are going to be concluding the training. So if you can do this, you'll be able to do only, of course, like, no, if you spent enough time and practice, like, you know, when you are learning this one. So this is how you are learning the integration concepts, and also you are learning like the Fusion manual things, and then you are also automating certain things, right? This is the second part, and the first part was SOA. The third part is ADF, which is optional. When I say optional, I'm not asking to learn this one mandatorily, but if somebody is interested, if somebody is thinking like they might be working in the custom application development, etc., then that would be ADF. In ADF, then we are going to work in a separate project, and there you are going to learn everything end-to-end application development, your business components. There's something called really similar to OAF. You're having your different business components, like your whatever, like the entity objects, view objects, application modules, all those concepts. And then there's something called page development, different components, like how to develop different layouts. And then your for developing ADF application, everything you're going to learn there. So that is the third thing. Okay. So yeah. So now you can ask the question. Sorry, I just put you on mute. But yeah, I hope I provided some idea what you're going to learn, how it will be useful. If you understand whatever is covered in this training, and if you spend some time, and because it's very important, you dedicate some time and work on these practices, practice all these things, then you'll be able to work on any kind of solutions, most of the solutions, what you'll be needing in your day-to-day job in the future. Okay, yeah. Gaurav, you have any, you can ask your questions. If I need any clarification, I can answer now. You need to unmute, sorry.
As I'm audible now?
Yes, now I can hear.
Yeah, I can go through with the SOA part. That is fine. Right. So I will get the practice with my local system for SOA as well, right? And the project also, if you are providing some.
Yeah. You're doing everything locally here. I'm going to give you all the resources what you need. Resources in terms of the complete software. And then I'm going to help you to install the software. And I'm going to give some XSD resources, XML documents. I'm going to provide everything what you need. I'm also going to give one PDF document which has end-to-end development of the project with complete steps and also the screenshots. Everything is available in that.
Oh, that's fine. And then the second part, the reporting tool and the customization, you say.
Yeah.
Okay. Mainly in Fusion, we have this type of the technical work for reporting and the minimum customization if you have the SAS certificate, right?
Can you ask that question again? Sorry, you are breaking.
Is audible now?
Yeah,
I have the in Fusion technical. You have just mean the technical apart from the integration perspective.
Yeah.
You have this reporting and the customization, the minimum customization which you can do, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So I will. But only the two type of reporting you tell, the OBIEE report and the
VIP.
VIP report.
Yeah.
Okay. But only the or no other report EBS, we have different type of record like RDF report, BIF XML report. We have the Discoverer as well.
No, okay. The RTF and all that is possible with BI publisher reports.
Okay.
And the OBIEE reports is enough for creating n number of things in OBIEE. Okay. And again,
what will the difference?
Sorry.
The difference between BI. What is the difference between OBIEE and BI report if it is an XML?
Yeah, the OBIEE report is this is used mainly for, we are depending only on the existing subject area. The subject area is you go to, for example, supply chain management, you go to the financials, you're having different subject areas. Subject area is a combination of already related objects. And you are going to build the reports only based on that one. Whereas if you go to BIP report, you can write your own SQL statements also. You can directly get the data from the backend database tables and views. That is not possible in case of OBIEE reports. OBIEE reports are always depending based on the pre-built subject areas.
Okay.
And this is also used for programmatically if you want to download the reports, etc. Ultimately, you have to go for BI publisher reports. And the BI publisher reports internally can also be depending on the analysis what we're creating here. That is also possible. And then you can download the report with the help of automated.
Okay. Yeah, Pascal, it seems fine from the course perspective. Okay, because firstly I want to go with the first and the second train. Not for the third one.
Yeah.
Because looking for the training now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, so
when will we start the batches? A great Pascal. I will proceed with the training. Okay. I will register for that. Yeah.
Sure. Okay. All right. Great. Yeah. Great, Gaurav. Thanks.
Yeah. Bye. Okay. Yeah. Bye. Thanks a lot, Pascal. I will be in touch with you for that. Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Bye. Thanks a lot.
No problem.
Yeah.